All right, what is going on, everybody? It has been a minute since I've posted to my YouTube. One reason for that is it's where I'm from in Ohio. It's been kind of on and off, nice and then not nice outside. So I've been trying to take advantage of that, go outside, golf, do whatever, just really be outside. But I still have been getting some Lego in. And today I'm going to show you some of the stuff I've been working on. And for starters, we're just going to hop right into this cute little guy. So this is actually from the Creator 3-in-1 Bunny Set. And you're probably wondering, well, it's Easter time, why didn't you just build the bunny? Well, I have a reason, because my wife wanted me to build the little seal, and it's extremely cute, so I decided to build it. And if you can see here, it's like his little mouth goes up and down. And he's got these cute little eyes that just stare right at you, little puppy dog eyes, but a little baby seal. And then he's got, you know, opposable arms and, or posable, I guess is the word, not opposable. But yeah, so you can kind of position him in different ways. Either way, he's going to look pretty cute. No, I'm probably not going to get another set of this to build the bunny, just because I like the little baby seal, and then it comes with a little tiny build right here. It's just a little tiny fish for him, so you can display that just like so. And next, we're gonna get into this guy right here. So this is the space astronaut. The space astronaut, once you build it, it comes with this pretty cool stand. And I think it's sweet because it kind of, I don't know, like you can display it just standing, but it's just not very stable, honestly. And the stand just adds another dimension because it kind of, you know, if you use your imagination, it's like he's flying into the air. But what I'm going to try to do without breaking it is take this off so I can show you guys some of the other cool features about it. So to start, we're going to look right here. It's got, this thing's so hard to hold without like trying to, that's one of the negatives. It's very like, I don't know if I have like dumb hands or what, but this is a set I had a hard time when I was putting a lot of different parts together without, like, you know, knocking one part of it off while I'm trying to put another part on. But as you can see, his arms move like this, and it's cool because you can kind of put them however you want. I thought about, it's hard because the leg snaps off, but like, you know, stretching them out, like making them do like the Jordan dunk from the free throw line. I thought that'd be kind of cool looking. And this thing moves too, so you can like move it in and out. You can move his hand to put it right here, you know, so it's like he's, you know, holding it. And then these are actually, I'll tell you right now, I'll go back down here so you can see. These are all stickers. Or, oh my gosh, these are not stickers. None of these are stickers. So that is really cool. So this right here is not a sticker, and you can't really see it, but this right here, kind of like his little keyboard thing. I don't know if you guys can see that. I can't tell where it's pointed because I'm just using my phone. But, yeah. So, and then he's got, you guys, you aeronautics and NASA people can correct me, but I'm just going to call it a jetpack. Looks like a jetpack to me right here. And this was probably, I don't know why I'm still on the ground, but this was the most like touchy aspect of it to build. It was like every time I would go to put a piece on, I would just smash everything else, and it's like, you know, it's okay because, you know, the final product is pretty sweet looking, not gonna lie. And then I'm not gonna do it, but the legs move as well. It's just, tell you what guys, it's hard to just like hold it and display it. So, but yeah, there you go. And the legs can go in and out. So when I put it back on the stand, kind of looks like it's like, you know, going up into space. And the last part I will tell you about this is, if you plan on building this and you like the like little hidden features or the Easter eggs, you know, don't listen to this part, but here we go. So this part right here actually flips down, and then you can flip this part up, and there is a little spot that you can place your minifigure in there. And here, there's another printed piece right there, another little control panel. So it's like a, you know, person inside of a person, kind of like a, I don't know the term for it, but it's pretty awesome in my opinion. Nice little Easter egg Lego threw in there for us. So there we are. You gotta flip that back down, put this back up, and he's ready to go. And let's see if I can catch myself on film completely destroying a Lego set by trying to do something simple like put the stand back in. Nope, I got it. First try. Wow, look at that. But I tell you what, guys, I'm so nervous about this sitting here. Oh, boy. Oh, man. All right. Here we go. So, we got these two out of the way. We'll move into a really cool piece that... So, this set is one of the ones that I got on my birthday. And I paid retail for it, which I'm not mad about at all, because I think it looks absolutely stunning. And I'm sure a lot of you guys will as well once I kind of get into detail here. So, bring it forward a little bit. As you can see right here, we have it's called the London telephone box. This had, I want to say, 1,460 pieces. And out of those pieces, 22 of them are new. So that's pretty darn cool in my opinion. 22 brand new pieces. And a lot of them are kind of like what would have to do, obviously, with a telephone box. And you can see right here, I don't know what this signifies, but if anybody wants to let me know, I didn't really research this part. Right here, each corner, like one, two, three, four, or side, not corner, they have these black crowns on them. None of these are stickers, so like they're all pretty cool looking printed pieces. And then you can see right here, this is the only sticker that isn't inside of it's not inside the telephone box. I keep wanting to call it a telephone booth because where I'm from, I feel like a lot of other people call it that too, a telephone booth, but maybe in London, they call it a telephone box. But yeah, try to think of what are the other new pieces in this. I think it's a 1x1, like all red, modified brick. So like a little tiny one with the like little stud on the side. Pretty cool. And what else here? So yeah, like the door does open and close. And obviously you got the like the little window pieces so you can see in, even with it shut, which is pretty cool in my opinion. And then this little piece in here, this is a phone book, which it actually comes out and it comes with a sticker on it. So there's a lot of stickers. So there's a bunch I didn't use because obviously there's two different versions of the phone that you can put inside of it. I did the most modern version because that's kind of like, that's still nostalgic to me because that was like in the 80s. And I did, obviously wasn't around in the 1920s, so I went with this version. And there's even more. Jeez, my hands have a hard time fitting in here. Oh boy. So, yeah, we're gonna put maybe. So we'll probably speed this part of the video up. Watch him like break it open. Oh jeez. All right. There we go. Anyway, so I guess I'll just take it off because I can put it back on, hopefully. Alright, yeah, that'll be easier to show. So, you get a little closer here, you can see that each one of these in here is stickers, and there's other combinations of stickers. You could use any ones you want. I just like staying true to the model and, you know, using the ones that they do. And, yeah, so you got your phone, you got the dial pad and some, you know, advertisements when you're inside of a phone box, phone booth. This sounds weird saying box. There's always advertisements. So you got your ideas here. Call 7810. And then visit Legoland, which I've never done. I'm going to do. Mark my words. I'll make a video of it. And big city sightseeing. Get tickets here.
And yeah,
so cool little details like that, but they are all stickers. So yeah, and while I've got it off, I will show you the another cool part about it. I don't know, because the light's on, if you can see it or not. Maybe I'll try to turn the light off, see what happens here. Oh, there you go. And yeah, it lights up on the inside. It's pretty awesome. It's not really, it's not designed to be on all the time. It's probably for, you know, times like now where you're doing a review or you're displaying it, whatever. You're telling somebody about the build. But anyway, yeah, it's pretty darn cool piece. And who really cares but me? It's my favorite color. This is like my absolute favorite color of red. We'll put this back on there. Hopefully. As I knock off a whole flower. Jeez. Alright, we'll worry about that one later. So, I don't have... Alright, I'll just do it without it. So, another cool feature of this, I'll use something maybe in place. What can I use? What can I use? Let's see here. Alright, so, came up with this brilliant idea with this thing, a secondary feature of it. It's like a phone holder or phone display, I guess. At least it's what it says anyway, but I feel like if you put your phone there, it is actually, like, my phone. It bends the fence back. I feel like that's a really cool feature, though, so I don't think I'm going to probably put my phone on it. I don't think I'm gonna put it somewhere where there's a lot of traffic, because I'd be pretty upset if this, you know, got messed up. But anyway, if you're feeling, a little frisky, it does supplement as a phone holder, as you can see. And one thing I do want to key in on real quick, I feel like I'm talking a lot about this, but the other ones will be quick because they're not built yet. But I love the brick in the background. And then there's a drain right in the back that it brings it to life. And you'll be able to see if you get the set. It's kind of like a cobblestone pattern on the, the ground landscape, which I just feel like the fan designer that did this, they put a lot of thought into all this. And then the final aspect of it, I think it's great. And, I was so excited building this whole thing. I didn't want it to end. I loved building this set. It was just soothing. Like, it never got boring. There was a lot of repetition, but it was just the building techniques were like, wow! Like, that just came out of that. Holy crap. So, next, it's my, we'll call it my backlog. We have the Creator 3-in-1 Exotic Peacock. And as you probably can't see it because it's hidden by a box right here, it's going to match really well with my exotic parrot because it's kind of like the same color style, which I love. I love those colors. They just stand out really well. And they have two alternate builds. One's a dragonfly and the other one's a butterfly. The dragonfly is cool. I feel like you'd probably end up with a lot of pieces afterwards that you didn't use. Which is fine, but that's how this was. There's an insane amount of pieces that I didn't have to use because it's not the main build. Same with the butterfly. It looks like it might have maybe a little more pieces, but either way, they're still cool builds. Like, they're very colorful, sticks out to you. 355 pieces. So I got this the other day at Walmart. And where I grew up in my hometown. So, yeah, I got this guy going on. And we'll jump in over here. I've done like two Technic sets ever. One was the recycling truck, which was awesome. Like, I thought it was great. It just took so long. Maybe it's just because I'm not used to Technic, but it's different. It just is. Like, I feel like my brain has to engage in a different way, and then your fingers. Anybody that builds Technic, they can tell you your fingers the next day will hurt. No matter how much you build, I'll tell you, if you're building Technic, they're going to be a little tendy. So right here, my mom got me this set. She got it in Pennsylvania. She was at like this, it's like a holiday wonderland place. They kind of do a bunch of different stuff depending on what the holiday season is. It's called Cranax. It's in, I think it's Hermitage is where it is. I used to go there all the time as a kid. But anyway, my mom was there and she picked this up for me, as you can see right there. Retail, she didn't really get like a crazy deal or anything on it, but she told me a lot of the sets they had, and they had a good selection. So if you're ever in Hermitage, PA, you can do some Lego shopping there. And here we are. It's the Lamborghini. So it has 806 pieces. I think the recycling truck had like 350 something, and that took me like 5 days. It was just, I'm not used to that. And but I am excited. I love how more intricate the, like, everything in my opinion, Technic has purpose. It functionality. It's really cool. I'm not saying I'm against it. It takes me a lot longer to build it, so you don't get that, you know, completion satisfaction right off the bat, which is fine because obviously it ends up looking pretty darn sweet. I don't know a lot about cars, but I have a good set amount of the Speed Champions that were released in the last year or so, which are fun to build. Not Technic, still cars, pretty sweet looking. So I'm going to save what's in this box for last. I mean, it's not like insanely exciting, but it's in a box and you guys don't know what it is. So I'm going to get to this right here. So I picked up the Alpine Lodge. I think this is a 2023 set. It's like the Christmas set from, I would say last Christmas. And I'm super pumped to build this set. I haven't really looked into how many minifigures there are. Maybe there might even be one hiding in this is an outhouse right here. I think that's really cool. But yeah, it's just a clean looking build, you know, with the, it's kind of like, you know, a log cabin. It's kind of Lincoln log looking, and I've always kind of been drawn to that. I love the log cabin look. It's just, there's a lot of cool stuff going on. So right over here, you see that they got an ice skating rink. You got a guy skiing, and then this person's on a snowmobile, and they're pulling a tree. You get a cute little kitty. Like I said, there might be a minifigure inside of the outhouse. I'm not sure, but as I can see right now, you get a cat. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 minifigs, and potentially one in the bathroom. I'm not sure. Comes with 1,517 pieces. So it says batteries included, so I'm guessing something in here lights up. I don't know what, but I'll tell you once I get it figured out. And there you go. The back, it's not completely closed in. It's an open back. Doesn't matter to me because when I display stuff, it's the front anyway. And it stands about, you can read here, it's almost 10 inches wide, 8 inches tall. Good size build right here. So it's probably going to take me a minute, but I'm really excited to build it. So yeah, here's the Alpine Lodge. It's, yeah, like you see right here, the Winter Village Collection. I was super pumped when I got this set. Lastly, of stuff that I haven't built yet. Put Peacock back up here. Lamborghini over here. We've got this guy. So I know what I bought. But let's open it up. Oh boy, it's what I bought. Amazon, you've done it again. All right, here we are. I love sets that I feel like you can display them and it doesn't look like a little kid. Well, I'll tell you, the box is wet, so that's not awesome. But anyway, this is what we got here. We got the bonsai tree from the Botanical Collection. It's not the box, I'll tell you what, this is a soggy box. This Yeah. Good thing everything comes, like, bagged itself and everything, because that would not be happy. But, as you can see, the bonsai tree, it's got 878 pieces, the botanical collection. I don't know if this is considered botanical, but I made my wife these a little while back, the roses. They're cool builds, like, honestly, like, they don't take long, and they're pretty satisfying just because they're, you know, they're flowers, and they never die. So, put those back up there. Ah, one of the petals fell off. I gotta figure out where. I'm not sure. That's okay. Flowers aren't perfect. All right. So, yeah. We got the bonsai tree. So what's cool about this set, other than the fact that it's a bonsai tree, and I want a real one too, because I don't know why, I've always thought they look kind of cool. And it comes with, you know, I guess you could say seasonal, like, leaves that come on it. I didn't do any research on bonsai trees, but obviously, at some point, they bloom into something really pretty like this, and they start looking like this. And I wanted to key in on something I'm excited to build is, it's just the, I guess, the base of it. It's not just like the tree and it's there. It's got rocks inside of it and a deck, and just looks like there was a lot of thought put into it. So I'm really excited to build this, and I hope you guys enjoyed looking at my backlog, I guess, and some of the stuff that I have completed. Lastly, I want to show you guys one more set that I've done just because it took me a long time and I completed it. Alright guys, hope you enjoyed. Those were some of my sets that I've been working on and some of the ones that I'm going to be working on in the near future. Thanks for watching and bye for now.